Good morning students. In this video class, I'm going to cover the last part of the unit 2, that is command line arguments. Command line arguments is a parameter supplied to a program when program is invoked means actually it is done at the command line, but nowadays we can supply those argument in IDE also. But to cover the actual concept of the command line argument, I am going to demonstrate those programs in the terminal. Okay, before going to that, so we'll go for example. Let us assume there is a utility or a software that is named as file copy. I want to copy the content of a file named as xfile.txt, that is source file, and to another file yfile.txt. So those who are already practiced DOS commands and also Linux commands, then they are very much familiar about this. Nowadays most of the softwares are GUI based, so many of you are not yet familiar with the command line arguments. Here is, this is the one simple example how to run the software in front of DOS prompt. So this is the DOS prompt. So when you go to command prompt in Windows or Windows XP or Windows 7 or any such Windows family operating system, you will get C:\, which is the DOS prompt symbol. So C is the drive letter, and here I am invoking the software file copy, and I am specifying the argument number 1. This is the first argument and this is the second argument, where the file copy is the file name where executable code of the program is stored. Means this is nothing but executable file. So this is very useful whenever we need to run a program and that program requires the information before the execution or before the invocation. So this is very useful whenever the program need not to provide information during the runtime. So really program run adnantra, so data kodo badlu prarambhadale kotbitre, so it is very useful in some situations. So C program, and not only C program, almost all high level languages provides support for command line arguments by some means. We'll go for the next series. Screenshot of a program that has been run, PS. This is in Linux. PS stands for process status. And I'm providing an argument here is, that is hyphen a. So command name or utility name here is ps, and the argument is supplied to it, that is hyphen a. So that is, here is command line argument. And here is one more, here is concatenation command, in short it written as cat. This is name of a command or utility. I am supplying an argument, so that is hello.c. here is hello.c is the argument provided to the utility cat. So this is the example for command line arguments. So this is example 1 and here is example 2, that is cat hello.c. And this is the method to provide the command line arguments in Linux. Let's go for in Windows. There is a one simple command, dir command, directory command. Here is command or utility is dir, and argument is provided to it, that is slash w. So slash w. So this is the output of the command. So what is the output here is, that's not important here is, you just observe that dir is the command or utility name or the executable file name of C program. So executable program of C program, and here is the command line argument. We have to provide such type of command line in the program also. So in the next slide, one more screenshot here is, observe that notepad, many of you are used notepad in Windows operating system, and we can open or create a new notepad by this method. Observe, it is notepad, that is the utility name, and I am supplying a name here, name of the file. If the file exists in this folder, that will be open, otherwise new file is created. So now go for how this achieved in C programming. Command line argument is supported in C language also, and to achieve that, we have to provide two arguments to the main function. So main function is the entry point of the program execution, because operating system will look for the code related to main, and from there C program execution starts. And for that, I will provide two arguments. One is argument counter, known as it is argc, argc, and argument vector, that is nothing but array, character array, and that is argv. And the information what we typed in the command line are passed to these variables by operating system. That means it is information contained in the command line is passed to the main function through operating system when a program execution is started. So the general form of main function with the support for command line argument is like this: int main, this is already familiar to you. Argument 1 int argc, that is count, and character pointer for set of 1. So sorry, here is it requires one more, that is square bracket, or otherwise asterisk 2. So 2 asterisk and argument b. So pair of square brackets required here is, then rest of the main function. Argc is an integer value, stores number of command line arguments passed by the user, including name of the program. So really program names aitale count agutte. Okay, coming to this one, and argument variable, that is array of character pointers listing all the arguments. So now I will go for one simple example code. Okay, the continuation here is, this is from the previous slide. If argc is greater than 0, then the array element from argv 0 to argv last one, that is argc minus 1, will contains pointers to strings, and in that argv, that is array of character pointers, in that first one is name of the programming. So name of the program, and after that till the last element, every element related to command line arguments. Here is the example. Observe, I will demonstrate how to do this program. Just before that, just go through this program. This is a program to find sum and average of given values using command line arguments. In the C program, we already done sum and average of sum and average of given values, but there we have to declare sufficient number of variables. If the number of variables are too much, then we will go for array. But again, in the array, we have to specify number of elements specifically. Either even though you can store less number than the existing capacity of the array, but still you have to provide it. Whereas here, I will provide the values during the runtime. I am not specifying how many values. I will just enter the numbers, then those numbers are added, their sum is found, and average is calculated. Here is argc and character values here. Int value is declared, that is to loop counter, and since I may enter float value also, so I selected float num sum average. Argument count is less than or equal to 2, that means invalid arguments. If there is no argument, that means only the name of the program is there, then I will get invalid arguments and argument count is 1. If argument count is 2, that means it will be only 2 arguments, whereas one of them is program name and only one number. I need at least 2 numbers to find something like this. So output is here is, let's forgo for this, here is output 1. I will run the program. Without providing any numbers, so I'll get the output invalid arguments. In the second one, I have given just only one number, again I will get invalid arguments, and after that program execution stopped because of exit 0 function is used. If the given argument is greater than 2, then I will go for sum equals 0, find the sum. Observe, it is, I have started from 1 and less than argument count. The reason is that this is argument variable 0, this is argument variable 1, and this is argument variable 2. So we have to find the sum of 33 and 43, not the name of the program. Hence, for this reason, I will start the counter value from 1, not 0, because 0 is name of the index for the name of the program. 1 to less than argument counter, that will be the end of the value. And observe here is, I have used a specific function a to f, that is alphabet to float. Here alphabet means here is whatever I have entered the input value, that is stored in character format, that is in alphabet. So alphabet to float, that means number conversion to be done, that is more specifically string to float conversion, string to float conversion. And the given value, that is 33 in this case, usually it is a string format, that is stored as a float value in the variable num. Then sum plus equals num, it is intuitive to you. So you can understand much better. After that, I will find the average by dividing the sum value by argc minus 1. Why minus 1 here is? The reason is that 0th index is for name of the program, so you should not consider it. So 1 less than the argument count is the actual count of the command line argument. So afterwards, I will get the information, that is sum of numbers and average of given number. So in the output 3, I will get the value, correct value for as the output for the given value. So now I'll go for running the program, and I will demonstrate, this is very important, running the command line argument, running the C programming with the command line argument is much different than the running the program in Genie. So now Here I have stored the C program, that is cat cmd arg dot c command line arguments, and have the result output is here, content of the C code. I will open this code in the command line argument. I will open it in genie. Observe that this is the same program what I have shown in the demonstration. See, here is in genie we already compiled the program by clicking on compile icon in the toolbar. Once I compile it, I will get a new file in the same folder. I will compile it. So compilation is success, compilation finished successfully, message will come. So after that, in the terminal lscmd star in long format, I got two file. One is the original source file, source code. Next one is the object file, but this object file does not execute independently. I have to build the code once again. So here is build the current file. Here also I will get the information, compilation finished successfully. It will take some larger time than the compilation. Okay, compilation finished. Now executable code has been created in the folder. It is in the same folder. I will go to the folder where it is created. Again I will give the command. Okay, got it. After that, cmd arg is the file name that is executable. I have to execute this. Once again go to the slide. Here is, I have to execute the file like this. I have to provide the path name dot slash cmd arg. I will go for the method clear. I will run the file dot slash cmd arg. I got the information invalid argument. The reason is that I not given any arguments to the function, program. I will run the program now. Once again cmd arg, this time I provide just one value. Once again I will get the output invalid argument. Try again. Now once again I will run the program cmd arg. This time I will provide two info values, 10 20. Let us see what will be the output. Sum of the given numbers here is 30, average of given numbers here is 15. Total there are 2, so 30 divided by 2 here is 15. So that means I am getting the correct answer. Again I will run the program. This time I will go for little bit larger number of information and also some float values. Value 34 23.4 78.3 22 78 52. So I can give any number of information, there is no limit here. So press enter key. I got the output. Here is 299.7. so there will be last float. Since I use float value in the fraction part, last digit may get some different answer, different value, but consider only this much, and this is the average of the given values. Likewise I can go for any number of value. Once again see, now I got the answer. So here it completes the introduction and demonstration of command line arguments in C language. go on to practice. I will share the code what I have demonstrated here in classroom app. Practice it whenever you go to the computer for the practice, the program and verify the output. Thank you.